Good morning, friends. In this video, I will discuss about the Maxwell equation and how one can use that for electromagnetic waves. And so, Maxwell equations are just using as a supporting physical concept to drive the electromagnetic waves. Right? So, this is the target. I have to drive the relationship for electromagnetic waves by using the Maxwell equations. And before I use these Maxwell equations for that concept, I want to say that I usually use this SPCs, that is supporting physical concepts, which are required for a purpose, right? And the purpose is the derivation of electromagnetic waves. In the last video, I have discussed about the application and the basic properties of electromagnetic waves and their frequency, wavelength, etc. Now, as you know that these are basic Maxwell equation, divergence of E is equal to rho upon epsilon naught, divergence B is equal to 0, the curl E is equal to minus del B upon del T. This is Faraday's law, right? This is Faraday's law, and del cross B is equal to mu naught times J plus mu naught epsilon naught del E upon del T, and this one is the Ampere's law. So we have to use basically these four equations, but in free space. This is the condition, because electromagnetic waves travel into the free space, and for the free space rho is equal to 0 and J is equal to 0. That means volume charge density and current density is equal to 0. So because of that, the Maxwell equation becomes, in free space, divergence is equal to 0, divergence B is equal to 0, Faraday's equation and that remains same, and the Ampere's law becomes like this, with this displacement current, mu naught epsilon naught del E upon del T. So these are the four equations which we have to use to drive the electromagnetic waves relation, and one triple cross product formula which you will require. So here A cross B cross C, as you know, that is equal to B A dot C minus C A dot B. So these are the two tools which we require to drive the relationship of electromagnetic waves, and these tools I basically as I told you, I say SPCs that I will discuss here. So how one can drive that? First of all, I am using the Faraday's law. This Faraday's law I am using in differential form, that is del cross E is equal to minus del B upon del T, time varying magnetic field, right? So now I am taking the curl, take curl of the equation. If this is equation number 1, so I am taking curl of it. So curl of this equation del cross E is equal to minus del cross of del B upon del T. So as you know, the left hand side, this one is E cross B cross C, you can say. And the right hand side, we have to rearrange the terms, right? So first of all, left hand side is equal to, this is A B C. So first of all, B, that is divergence, and A and C, A this and this one, divergence of E, and second minus, I'm using the, it will better to write here again. So B A dot C minus C A dot B, it will help to me also. This minus sign and C is your E, so E remains outside, and this divergence dot del, right? So if I simplify it, so I have to use Maxwell equation, and for the first equation, you know, divergence of E is equal to 0, so this term del operator and 0 minus E del del dot, that becomes del square. So I can write that in this way. So this term is equal to 0, so So I can write it only minus del square like this one. So this is our left hand side. Now what about the right hand side? If I use a right hand side and this right hand side minus del del cross del b upon del t can be written as minus del upon del t del cross b, right? So now I have to use the Ampere's law and I have to put that value here. As you know that del cross b is equal to, so this side I can write minus del upon del t mu naught epsilon naught. This was the formula, right? Maxwell fourth equation. And as a result this becomes minus mu naught epsilon naught del 2e upon del t square, right? So this is the left hand side and this one is the right hand side. So in the next page what I will do, I just put it equal and removing this minus del square e is equal to minus mu naught epsilon naught del 2e upon del t square. This minus cancel out, so I am using this cancel out and writing as del 2e is equal to mu naught epsilon naught del 2e upon del t square, right? So here you observe that this is the required result for the electric field component wave, and this del square, as you know, can be written as this is Laplacian operator. This is del square upon del x square plus del square upon del y square plus del square upon del z square, right? So if I put that value here, then it will be three dimensional. It means E is function of x, y, z then that time. So E will be function of x, y and z, right? So in general this is not true. I will show you it. So this is E x I plus E y j plus E z k in general, which you write the electric field vector. So the question was, I have to put it here or no? No. In the first case, why? Because in electromagnetic wave, if I show you this is an electromagnetic wave and electric field component vibrate like this one and traveling according to this direction, that is x, and this is y direction. So electric field components are vibrating perpendicular to the direction of propagation, right? And that is only one direction, which is y direction. So you are observing electric field component along the y direction, right? And variation into that in terms of the magnitude. So E y, and it is function of only x, and at any time t you can observe the magnitude. So this is x t. So here I need only one parameter, that is x. So I will use only this one. So I can write this equation, this one, like del 2e upon del x square is equal to mu naught epsilon naught del 2e upon del t square. One more important point actually that observed by the Maxwell, he actually defined the speed of light with the help of this constant. First of all, as you know that c is equal to 1 upon a square root mu naught epsilon naught, right? So this mu naught epsilon naught will be equal to 1 upon c square. So instead of this one, I can write del 2e upon del x square is equal to 1 upon c square del 2e upon del t square, right? This is arrow. So this equation is similar which you have seen in your early days in plus 2 or when plus 1, when you have seen this equation d2y upon dx square is equal to 1 upon b square d2y upon dt square, where y was the function of x and t, right? That simple harmonic motion for this wave, you have seen it already. So here v is the velocity. Here c is the velocity, that is the speed of light. So right, so electromagnetic wave basically travel with the speed of light that you can define from here. So this was the required result, del 2E upon del x square is equal to 1 upon c square del 2E upon del t square. So in the left hand side you see the variation into x and right hand side t. So E is a function of only x and t here. This is one dimensional, right? So here this is the required result, and you can explain it or can say that electric field component vibrating along the y direction and the wave propagate along the x axis, right? So similarly you can derive for the magnetic field component. It will take little more time and I can show you that also, and how basically you can derive the for magnetic field component. So for magnetic field B, if I have to derive the wave equation, so how I can derive that? So I will use the Ampere's law. By using Ampere's law. So what is that? I will use that in differential form, that is del cross B is equal to mu naught epsilon naught this del E upon del T, right? So again the process is same. I will use the curl of this equation. So by taking the curl of equation number 1, that you can say this is equation number 1. So left hand side del del cross B, this is the result, and the right hand side you can write del cross and rest of the term as it is right now, del E upon del T. Okay, right? And now as you know the result of it, A cross B cross C. So first of all you apply the triple cross product in the left hand side. So you can write the statement here by using your triple cross product in the left hand side formula, right? That is A cross, you can write here B cross C is equal to B A dot C minus C A dot B. So left hand side becomes, that is del cross B, right, is equal to del del dot B minus B del dot del, similar as you have did earlier. As you know that divergence of B is equal to 0, right? It signifies that monopole does not exist. When you put this value here, you will get only this this term, and del dot del is equal to, you know, that is a Laplacian operator, del dot del is equal to del square, right? So in the left hand side you will get this del square and this B, while the right hand side, if you see here, this is del cross of this term. So rearranging the term, if I rearrange the term, so it becomes mu naught epsilon naught del cross, and again this del E upon del T. Further I can write little more, mu naught epsilon naught and del upon del T like this, and del cross T, you know this. I can write here this statement at this particular step also, but I just try to show that how I am rearranging the term. So this is the left hand side, right hand side. So here this is del cross E, so I will put the value of it from the Faraday law. So on the next page I will show you. The left hand side is minus del square B, and the right hand side is minus mu naught epsilon naught del upon del T and this del cross E, right? So I am putting the value of del cross E from the Faraday law. So you know that minus mu naught epsilon naught del upon del t. There is so there is no negative sign here right now. Yeah. So I put here it by mistake. So I'm erasing it. Right. Again, I'm using the pen, and this del cross mu naught epsilon naught mu naught epsilon naught and del upon del t, del cross is equal to minus del b upon del t. So the right hand side becomes minus mu naught epsilon naught and del 2 b upon del t square, similar as we have seen for the electric field component. So minus del square b is equal to minus mu naught epsilon naught del 2 b upon del t square, right? So here minus cancel out this one, and you have this equation del square b is equal to mu naught epsilon naught del 2 b upon del t square. So this is mathematical derivation, so you can derive it easily. If I put the value of Laplacian operator in case of one dimension, then it becomes del square b upon del x square, and the value of mu naught epsilon naught, now you know that is 1 upon c square, and this is del 2 b upon del t square. So by this way you can write the electromagnetic wave equations for electric component as well as of magnetic field component. The electric field component, it was del 2 e upon del x square is equal to 1 upon c square, and this was del 2 e upon del t square. Right, in the last slide I have shown you the electric and magnetic field component in a way that I can show you in the next picture, how basically you observe the electromagnetic field wave. So this is x direction, this one is the y direction, and this is the z direction. How the magnetic field and electric field component vibrates, that I can show you by this way. You can see this is the electric field component, and you can see it by this way, right? So electric field components are vibrating along this direction, that is y direction, and waves moving towards the x direction. So you can see here this is E along the y direction and moving along the x axis. The second one, the second one is the magnetic field component, which is vibrating along the z direction, you can see here, and the wave is propagating along the x axis. So the field component you can see in this way, and the wave is propagating along the x direction. So magnetic field component along the z direction and wave propagating x. So this is the graphical representation of the electromagnetic wave, in which you have observed the electric field component and magnetic field component, right? So in the next video I will discuss about that, if EY is given, so how one can find out the next component, that is the magnetic field component. If you have any question, you can asking from the comment box, or you can visit this video or similar video here at apnephysics.com. So thanks for watching this video and for your time.